Tonight, the Cook Report reveals a shocking trade in human flesh. Hundreds of thousands of European women being sold into sexual slavery. And we expose the amazing secret life of this international surgeon, who's also an international pimp, based in Britain.
You're a pimp, aren't you? Nothing but a pimp.
Sarah Forsyth's life has been ruined by the sex trade. She's agreed to tell her story tonight in the hope of saving other young women from a life of torture and misery. What a wicked game to play. Tonight we go underground into the sordid world of the traffickers in women, where the forces of law and order are overwhelmed and the profits run into billions of pounds. Sarah managed to crawl out of the murky waters of prostitution, but paid a high price to be able to walk free in her hometown today. Her experience makes horrific reading. At 19, she was forced into prostitution, and her pimp made her a cocaine addict by the age of 20. By the time she was 21, she was anorexic and alcoholic. She's tried to kill herself 8 times. While Sarah was being forced into prostitution, the people of war-torn Chechnya were receiving medical aid from life-saving surgeon Michael Schubert. He used to help women like this. Now he helps himself.
The situation is very serious, and I'm very shocked what I saw here.
2 years ago, he appeared on News at 10 to expose the terrible conditions after the country's war with Russia.
I've never seen that before.
Don't speak English very well. But back in London, he lives the life of a pimp, luring girls from Eastern Europe with promises of huge earnings and putting them to work in the illegal sex industry. It's a double life the Cook Report can now expose. He's a qualified surgeon. He's worked in Chechnya, Rwanda, and Sri Lanka. He uses his company to get visas for girls and says he has more than 20 prostitutes working in London already. Every year, according to European Community figures, 500,000 women are trafficked for sex. Mostly from places like this, behind what once was the Iron Curtain. Here in Budapest, for example, in one 24-hour period, a new breed of international super pimp offered to sell us more than 100 women to use or abuse as we chose, no questions asked. This Hungarian gangster thinks he's about to sell a group of East European girls to a businessman to work illegally in British brothels. Julia Gatti traffics girls for sex anywhere in the world. Behind his legitimate facade, he's a big player in the business. He uses a school photography company as a front for his real occupation as a trafficker in women. He's on the wanted list with Interpol, and says he can supply us with women from 11 countries. We'll see what he has to offer later. In happier times, Sarah Forsyth trained to be a nursery nurse. As her school record shows, she was a model student.
I'm a very happy person. I've got a great personality. My ambition is to go to America when I'm 25 to live, have a job and family.
As a first job, she applied for employment in a creche in Amsterdam, attracted by foreign travel, the promise of good wages and valuable work experience. Magic people, voodoo people. Within days, the man who hired her, John Rees, had taken her passport, forced her into cocaine addiction, and threatened her with an electric stun gun to make her work in the windows of Amsterdam's red light district on permanent display to her never-ending stream of customers. Eventually, Reese was caught and jailed for 2 years. Sarah is still a drug addict. Her voice is permanently slurred by the tranquilizers that blot out the nightmares that still haunt her.
After I finished work, I used to play Russian roulette with her. And after I finished work, I used to get to bed, sleep for about half an hour to an hour. He'd get him up, our locked room, guarded by a pit bull dog. And he went, he cooks on there, get a shower and go leave for work.
So you were virtually a slave?
Yeah. That's what I want. I went from being a nursery nurse to that. And now my life's ruined, so everyone knows. Sarah was a prostitute.
It took 6 months of counselling before she could even bring herself to tell the police what had happened to her.
It certainly was a nightmare for Sarah. I don't know how she survived it, even though she has survived it in the current state she's in. The drugs were plentiful, the alcohol was given to her. That was her only food, in effect, for several months, drugs and alcohol and sweets. The situation was unbelievable.
Sarah is still traumatized. She was also forced by her pimp to watch a video in which a prostitute is actually murdered, and he told her she'd die the same way if she didn't work harder.
He went, watch it. He went, because if you don't work the window money, he said, that's what'll happen to you. He said, you're on a £50,000 contract to me. He said, and if you don't make that money, he says, I'll put you in a movie like this. He said, and I can make a million off you.
Her diary tells the shocking story of her decline in captivity.
Thursday, 2nd. Sad, feel dirty, frightened, took crack and hash. Saturday, 4th. Starting to wonder what I am. Hate men. Tuesday, 7th. Sad, frightened, just want to go home. Saturday the 11th, feel like dying, slut. Thursday 16th, I just want to wake up out of this nightmare, sick of guns, alarms, men I hate. I just lie and wish 10 minutes would pass, it seemed like hours.
The sex industry has an insatiable appetite for a constant supply of young women. International surgeon Michael Schubert lures new recruits via his medical consultancy business in London, specializing in girls from poor Eastern European countries. He preys on women who advertise in newspaper Lonely Hearts columns. The sales pitch we intercepted mentions huge earnings and nothing about a life of prostitution. A Cook Report undercover team replied and arranged a meeting with Dr. Schubert.
Mike. Hello, I'm Pam. Nice to meet you. This is Elena.
Hi. Nice to meet you.
Thank you for coming along.
Nice to meet you.
Yes, yeah. Have a seat.
How are you?
I'm fine, would you like?
He soon spells out the very tempting sums his girls can expect to earn as escorts in London.
But some of them, they earn literally £5,000, £6,000, £7,000 per week.
How much?
5,000-7,000 per week. And especially in this area, there's some Arab people, so when you go out for them 2-3 hours, they give you £500, £600.
I mean, let's be honest, is it escort work? Is it involved sex?
Huh? Does that involve sleeping with the...
Well, that's absolutely up to you to decide.
Huh? Yeah.
Hey, you're a friend of yours.
He says he uses his medical consultancy company as a front to provide his girls with credit cards, extended visas, and apartments to use as brothels. This time, he takes our bait, $500, to smooth the way into prostitution for the girls we tell him we'll be sending over from Eastern Europe very soon.
Thank you very much, Mike.
Bye.
We con him into thinking we're flying in two girls from Slovakia to take him up on his all-inclusive pimps package. In fact, they're Cook Report researchers. He'll charge £35 to smooth the girls' entry into the sex trade. For another £35, he'll put their business cards in London telephone boxes. For £140 a week, he'll advertise their services in newspapers. And he says he has friends who'll use them when times are tough. Schubert calls the girls to a flat he plans for them to work in. His company is to pay the rent, and they have to work in the illegal sex trade to pay him back £440 a week.
How many girls are working here at the moment?
He tells them he already has a network of girls working in the centre of London.
20, 22 or so at the moment.
Right.
But they're all in some north of Hyde Park, in the Queensway area.
Yeah.
And some in Knightsbridge area, which is further there.
Yeah.
So, and
he then shows them the advertisement he'll use to sell the girls in newspapers and telephone boxes.
Right.
It's his own personalised telephone number. There's no mistake. The phone number even spells out his name. He's trapped them into prostitution after all his early talk of innocent evenings escorting men round London. He takes £140 from them for 1 week's advertising and promises them they'll quickly earn it back once they're hard at work. Schubert claims he's still working for the respected Merlin Medical Relief Agency, a nasty shock for Merlin's boss.
I'm very, very surprised because he left us in October last year categorically, and he's got no business at all to actually be saying that.
And what's your reaction to his current business?
I'm horrified because it is totally out of the context that I've seen him in, which is as a very strong field operator. And I think it's doubly worrying to think that somebody from that background, a qualified surgeon with great skills and a very strong humanitarian background, should be undertaking activities that you allege.
At the flat, the former war zone medic dispenses some business advice.
If somebody comes here, and the minimum charge, which you can charge, I think is £40-50. Upwards.
Is that for the sex? £40?
Yeah, £40-50. So. But if you don't want to stay for an hour, you can ask for £80, £90.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. But always get the money before.
Hardly a doctor's prescription. After the break, we make a house call on the doctor.
Dr. Schubert, my name is Roger Cook from Central Television. I want to know why you're acting as a pimp.
And in Hungary, we'll meet the man who's prepared to sell these beautiful women to the Cook Report. One of the key staging posts for trafficking in women is here in Budapest, where affluent West meets aspiring East and its highly organized criminal fraternity.
Behind Budapest's beautiful facade, an evil trade is flourishing. This city is home to one of Europe's most notorious traffickers in women, Gyula Gáti. He's a local mafiosi whose cover is as a school's photographer. Already wanted in Denmark, he's keen to replace business lost there with new business in London.
A member of the Cook Report team has arranged to meet Mr. Gáti in a city centre hotel. We've told him we want to buy girls for illegal brothels. We say we run back in Britain.
Monica. Okay, how do you do?
Sorry. Good.
He says he can get us as many women as we want, but through his interpreter, he tells us he wants a monthly cut of their earnings.
£150 each every month for each girls.
Day in, day out, he traffics women like any commodity. Some don't know they're going to be sold into the sex industry. He lists the countries he procures them from.
Ukraine, Moldavia, Romania, Bulgaria, Russia.
Publicly, Gatti claims that all his girls are showgirls or dancers. But then, in the paperwork he provides with them, there's an age certificate for each and every one, not something you'd expect a dancer might need. Privately, he admits, of course, the girls are for sale for sex, and also that although he may be the most notorious trafficker, he's not the biggest. This man is Janos Petu. And he gets straight down to business through our interpreter.
How many girls are we talking about right now?
To start, 10 to start immediately. Well, not immediately, in the next few weeks. And if it works well, we'd have no objection to running a string of 100.
Mr. Petu works out the cost of the deal there and then. He's got 1,500 girls available and, like any trader, wants his pound of flesh from those we buy.
Well, which way do you want to play this? Do you want to have a sum of money in advance or a weekly commission off their earnings?
You want to end up with those dollars going to my night.
There. Jock ain't it?
Yeah.
He said you'll be happy with $20 per day per girl.
Mr. Petu thinks he's done a deal to get our 100 girls in 4 weeks' time. Now it's back to Mr. Gatti, who wants to conclude his own business arrangement with us. He's offering a group of Ukrainian dancers, whom he'll happily sell into the sex trade in London. He provides us with these pictures of the girls, all desperately hoping for a better life in the West, and puts us in touch with the Russian mafia figure who controls them. A toast clinches the deal, or so Mr. Gatti thinks. We have other plans for him. All our information on the activities of Mr. Gatti and Mr. Petu have been handed to the Hungarian police. Although the forces of law and order tried desperately to combat the Russian mafia and its extreme and bloody violence, the gangsters keep a firm grip on businesses like international trafficking in women. One organization trying to stop this trade is the Global Survival Network. In Moscow, it infiltrated the gangs and filmed secretly. Their footage hasn't been seen on television before. Faces have been masked to protect undercover agents.
Would like to travel to another country?
This Russian girl doesn't know she's being interviewed for a job in the sex trade, nor that she certainly won't be working in the locations she fondly imagines for herself as a dancer.
Paris.
Paris, Florida. Okay.
The reality is more likely to be here in a German sex club, sold into prostitution, in debt to her pimps, who'll sell her on like a farm animal when they tire of her. The clubs are full of trapped women.
We do consider this as a modern form of slavery because if you define slavery as not being able to control what happens to you, you know, women are not free. They are literally locked up or psychologically locked up because they see no way out of the situation. They are literally being sold from one trafficker to another. just like the slaves in old time.
And the penalty for crossing the East European mafia is execution. These prostitutes and their pimps were murdered in their brothel in Frankfurt for not obeying the orders of the men with the guns. No stranger to guns and threats herself, Sarah Forsyth gets ready to return to the scene of her nightmare. Magic people, voodoo people. It's 2 years since she was last in the Amsterdam red light district. Even accompanied by the Cook Report, she's scared of being dragged back into the life she left behind.
I've never been as nervous in my life since I've walked out of the place. Sex Palace, Peep Show, I've worked in there. See them two windows, that purple and red light opposite?
Yeah.
That's my window.
That was your window.
And in that window now, new flesh and blood ready for exploitation.
I'm not bothered, me. They can do what they want to me as long as I know that a few girls have been saved and they're out of them windows. Did you look at their eyes?
Yeah.
Did they look as if they want to be there?
Her tour brought back horrific memories. Now receiving proper medical help, she finds the strength to pass on her message.
What would you say now to anybody who saw an ad like you saw?
Don't do it or check it out properly. Like, every girl, like, thinks, oh, yeah, I'll be a nursery nurse and I can go abroad and work. It's not that easy. Because they con you. You get locked up. Just be careful.
In London, our two researchers head for the flat where Dr. Schubert is to help them with their first night's work as prostitutes.
In a few minutes' time, an investigation which has run for almost 6 months will come to an end. Dr. Schubert is due to arrive, he thinks, to expand his network by helping our girls set up a brothel over at number 41. What he doesn't know is that we're calling the tune.
A few minutes later, Dr. Schubert's on his way up.
Is the phone working now?
No, it's not, actually.
The not-so-good doctor pays his final house call.
I don't bother what to do. That's absolutely up to you. But, I hope you can pay the rent and all that.
Dr. Schubert, my name is Roger Cook from Central Television. I want to know why you're acting as a pimp. Why you're advertising sexy girl massage. Why you are betraying your training as a doctor. Yes, you are. You're betraying your training as a doctor. You're a pimp, aren't you? Nothing but a pimp. We've been filming you for weeks. You claim you had 22 girls working in London.
That's not true.
That's what you claim. We filmed everything you've said. You are nothing but a pimp. Luring girls across from Eastern Europe.
No,
that's what you say you do. That's what your flyers said. That's what you've told us. Escorting nice gentlemen, and what do you get instead? Sexy girl massage in telephone boxes. You should be ashamed of yourself. Come and face the music, Dr. Schubert.
Everyone knows. Sarah was a prostitute.